Hello dear students, welcome in this online session of 10th standard, and today we are going to take a very beautiful chapter which is depending upon the history and the conceptualization on India. Now as we know that India is a place where we all are right now located, and it is a place also where we feel secured and safe to hear. But apart from that, if you talk about India, then India is actually abide of some of the stories, concept, theories and basic relative fact also. So this is actually the lecture depending upon your textbook, the first flight, as you can see out there, 10th standard English. It will also make you understand the theory related to the glimpses of India. Now what is glimpses of India? That we will discuss here in this chapter. In this chapter, we'll also learn about that how and in which condition in the ancient time the people were dealing with their businesses and their other relative facts too. So now let me make you introduct before the starting chapter, because this chapter is actually divided, this whole of the 7 chapter is divided into basic 3 parts. The first part will be studied right now, that is the baker, a baker from Goa. Now you might be thinking that what kind of baker he may be, okay, because this is textbook reader, and in this case you will understand the baker from Goa is a kind of a theory where we will understand that what Mr. Lucio has given us some kinds of informative fact related to the bakery of Goa. Now see my dear student, the bakeries of Goa are right now also famous in the ancient time also, it was famous and all time it will be famous here. But the thing is that what you actually conceptualize, you relate your memory with your nearby bakeries and all, or the peddlers who were coming inside the society to sell any kind of sweet material, sour material, eatable, toys, balloons and all. You might have always attached yourself to that kind of people, so that you might be also feeling that okay, at the time they must be like your friends members and all. So we'll take this kinds of lesson only in this chapter of the glimpses of India. So in this lecture we'll understand the first part, then in the other lecture we'll go to the second part, and the third I'll be making you to get the essence of tea from Assam. So let's start the chapter. So this chapter is actually depending upon the bakery and the bakery person, means the loaf, the breads. The loaf means what? It's a French sliced bread which is sweet in the taste, not very much, not very less, somehow like a medium size of the sweet taste it is there. Apart from that, when the bakery is making this kinds of things, it is not only the factory where the students, the kids, the old men are relating with. No, it's already not like just a fact, it is factory, it is more than a factory, than to a relative fact of the we can say memory related to the people who are living inside the Goa. So in this kinds of lesson my dear student, you will understand the theory and the concept where the Goa and Goa's bakeries are actually been targeted well, okay. So now our elders are often heard resonating some kinds of nostalgically sound. Now what is nostalgically sound? The sound which is actually produced from the ancient time or from the olden days, which is making you to remember some kinds of memories and all. So the Portuguese and their famous loaf bread are still now existing in Goa, and that's how the mixture of the bread, the molders, the furnace, everything has right now also actually working in the same condition like it was working in the ancient time. So the author says that when he was young, he used to eat the breads, he used to run behind the breads, and especially this bread or the other bread related material, the bakery related material, was sold out internally to the village by a peddler who was always making a special kind of sound by presenting of the bamboo sticks and some other iron material with that. So he was just trying to recall everyone, remember everyone. And the peddler, the person who used to come in the Goa, or the person who used to come in the area of the village where he used to sell his breads, empty his bucket, is also the part of a story which is narrated by our author, that is the Lucio Rochex. So what is happening when somebody is coming, my dear student? When somebody is coming in our area, we used to go behind them, we used to just call them. And in that case we can say okay, when they're coming with the traditional bakeries like bamboos and all, hurdling some of his arrival sound in the morning and all, so it can be also still heard in the villages. So soon the carriers could be the like they were carrying the family profession who were carrying the family professions? The bakery people from the Goa's bakery family. So their forefathers, their grandfathers, their all the fathers may have made this situation that they will work only in the bakery. Now the latest generation's people or their kids, when they have grown up, they are also making this bakery to be working on. And the same thing the author is telling, that today also we find that bakery is on with the burning chimney and the loaves and bread. May have the visitors lost, it may have the eaters have lost, but the makers are there, still they are there. So during our childhood, he is telling that okay, the baker used to be our friend. We used to give the high five. Then the baker used to be our companion and the guide to here. And also he used to come at least twice a week or twice a day sometime. So that once when we set out in the morning, he's selling round and round, and also then again and again, then we have to make himself attached with us so that he can give us some of the breads. Even when somebody was actually inside the balcony, inside the park, inside the ground, inside the house, near the window pane, they could be running for this kinds of bakery wallahs and all. So sometimes the baker made musical entry. What is that? Musical entry. Obviously, every peddler means what? A person who is selling something. Every peddler needs to do a musical entry or a tonal voice so that people could go and attract by him. And that's how this lesson is dealing out. So we are actually reading the first lesson of this trio topic of the Glimpses of India, that is a baker from Goa. Now the baker made his musical entry inside the village, since with the jing-zang sound specially, which is actually made from the bamboo stiff. He was making a stiff with the bamboo and then he was producing this kinds of sound. Other on the hand banged the bamboo on the floor also to make some sound louder. So therefore everybody could be greeting him, running behind him and all. And somehow the lady of the house was with the good morning, and the places were also filled with a joyful nature when he was coming there. So everybody could wish him good morning, uncle, good morning. And he could be just keeping his load downside, and he will say, yes, auntie, kitna bakery ka saman de do, just tell me out. How much toast you need? How many bread you need? What amount of food you want to eat? There are some kinds of special pancakes also and all. So I can still recall the typical fragrance of the loaves, the bread, sweet breads. Fragrance means scent of that, the smell of that. Still, and why should we worry, he's saying that. No worries about the rubbing of our teeth or brushing of our teeth. We just run to eat that kind of thing. We used to pull the baker's basket downside to see what is there inside that, and there should be a gathering crowd could be occurring there. So we were so crazy for this bakery person who was actually a peddler, and he was coming from the bakery of Goa to give this kinds of sweet material, the loaves and all. Therefore nobody cares about the toothbrush also. And why should necessary also? It should not be necessary, because we all were at the time the kids, as the author says that we all were kids at the time, and we used to eat that kind of things, and we don't worry about any kind of other people to hear. So that's the thing which we are actually understanding in this bakery lesson, that is the baker from Goa. Not only this, my dear students, see, you, me, we all are connected with some of the memories. We are not the robotics. We have actually got birth biologically, and later on I can say that we have also got the informative fact in which we are attaching ourselves with some of the memories, some of the conclusion of the childhood days, adult days, old age, and then we have to go from here. So that's how this is the basic thing which we are actually needing out here. Now marriages, gifts and all meaningless without this kinds of bakery wallahs and all. So the marriages and the gifts must have a special occasion or special department specially for the arrangement of this bakery people. Cakes, pancakes, then we can say other kinds of things like bolinas and all, this all should be gathered there. Even in the festival too, this all the kinds of things were available to eat. And especially in the category of the Christmas at the time, all the festivals were somehow like mixed out, and bread, bakery materials and sweets and all, everything could be seen out here. So still thus the furnace is burning, the presence of bakeries is there, but there is not that same peddler who is coming to the village. The peddler has changed, the cooks have changed, but still the fragrance of the loaves are the same. That is making the memory about the bakers of Goa. Literally the bakers or the bread makers, the sellers, those days had peculiar dress. They wore a peculiar dress that is known as kabai, K-A-B-A-I. Now what was it? It was like a piece of long frock reaching to the, we can say down to the knees, and also at that time they were using some kinds of different language to hear. So in the childhood we saw the bakers wearing shirt and the trousers, they were shorter than even today the pants are. And even today if anyone is wearing any half pants or other kinds of pants, then we just call them like the paddlers, or we call them kabal, or we call them like the bakery person, you know. So that's how like we just make ourselves concerned and attached with this kinds of people who are actually relating with our memories and all. So that's how even today also, even anyone who is wearing a half pant like the bakery wallahs and all, then even today we just call the names, we just comment them as a paddler. Hey paddler, how are you? Hey half pant pehna yaar, it's very nice. So in this case we can say that the bakery and the bakery person, the low F smell, everything is relating with an sweetful emotions, an enormous emotion towards the author. And that's how the bakery usually collects his, the bakery wala means the baker usually collect his bills like in the end of the month or twice a month. And monthly bill account was also created from my house, because daily we used to eat this, and most of the time he used to visit our home. Always we looked happy at that time and prosperous as well. They also looked happy and prosperous. So their plum and physique was an open testimony, in which they were even today also we can understand that this, their faces are like jackfruit, we actually call them, and appearance is easily compared to the baker. So today also the families from the bakery wallahs, the bakers are so happy since from the ancient time their business is going well. How the people have changed, the time has changed, the sellers have changed, the buyers are changed, but then also the fragrance, the taste, the furnace is same. And that's how we all, whenever we grow, my dear student, whenever we grow, we don't remember the latest thing, but we remember the ancient thing. What happened in your past, you must have remembered, and that will create some kinds of very sweet fragranceful memory inside your own conscience. And you'll miss those days. You'll miss those days when your pocket was filled with only 2 rupees, 5 rupees, but you were happy. And today, though you might be having 100,000 lakh rupees in your pocket, but that happiness which actually hold it by you, which actually surrounding you inside your childhood days, inside eating the small toffees, will be not getting today. So that's how I can say that the bakeries and the baker from Goa, the lesson which is giving you the first part, the baker from Goa is actually connecting you and me with our olden past days. That's how this part is actually getting to be finished out. So in the next part we'll be going to the Coorg, by which is actually given by Lokesh Abrawal. Okay. Coorg. And before this, in the other part, we started to learn about and understand the bakers from Goa. So what is in this lecture that we need to understand today actually? Now the Coorg itself is a zone where you are actually relating with the coffee. Now generally if you are relating with the coffee, or you are having habitual habits to get the coffees and all, somehow it can be good, but addiction is not good. So we need to understand, we need to keep some kinds of control also on that here. So moving further, in this lecture we'll also understand some of the detail and factor related theories too, where we'll understand what is specially Coorg known for, why the Coorg is actually known as the paradise of India, and what is specialties of the Coorg, why the people used to go there. This all the factor and category we'll learn in this lecture. And also I'll make you to understand some kinds of extra gyan, if it is available then I'll also give you that. So don't you worry about that. This is actually the textbook first flight, and this is actually the lesson which we are going to refer, that is the second part of Glimpses of India, Coorg. Coorg is actually a coffee country, as we know that, you all know that. It is famous for its rainforest and spices too here. Later on, if you talk about into the Coorg, then we can say it is also known as the paradise of our earth. Like it's a part of a heaven which is slipped from the God's hand to the earth. And that's how we need to understand men and nature. It means the humanity with the natural things are combining together here, and that's how we can say that the Coorg is totally designed out by the God, Almighty God. So here we need to understand that midway in the between Mysore and in the coastal town of Karnataka, or you can say Mangalore, sites placed between heaven, just like same as like heaven. So it is actually must have, you might be thinking it have drifted, it may have drifted from the kingdom of the God, and that's how this Coorg is actually made out here or located out. So this is the land of rolling hills, also inhabited by the proud race, metal men also, and the beautiful women too. Now why we call the martial mans and all, because they were relating with our Indian freedom fighting movement since from the ancient time, and that's how Kodagu or Coorg, the smallest district of Karnataka, is also one of the home for the evergreen rainforest too here, and that's how the Coorg is located. So do you imagine the feeling and the fragrance of the atmosphere, the sound of the birds, and also the animal, the birds making some chirping sound, the animal clattering sound, the cloud clattering, and all, it's like mesmerizing beauty which you wanna go and see. And that's how I'm making you understand by the words that what can be the feeling if you actually visit the Coorg or the Coorgi zone too. Now dear students, we need to understand that God has made this much beautiful earth, then what we need to do, say dekho, we don't need to make the earth, we just need to protect the earth. Earth will make itself, so we need to protect it out here. Wildlife, forests, sanctuaries, and all are can be seen inside the Coorg zone, and that's how evergreen rainforest covers almost all the 30% area of this district, and that's how evergreen rainforest are also there. So somehow it is pouring whole of the month, whole of the year, keeps to the visitor away. Sometimes it is pouring in such a heavy manner that the visitors are also kept away from there. Away from there means the visitors are also not coming to visit Coorg because of the heavy rainfall too here, and that's how we can say that okay, if you want to go there, you can go in the no summer days there, then only you can go and visit that kind of areas. So here somehow still it is like March or the September is the perfect month to go and visit that out here. Now the weather is perfect, as you know, in the Coorg and all, and somewhere it is somehow pouring also, somehow good measures of the weather can be there, somehow good fragrance of the fruits can be there, somehow monkeys can be there, somehow you can see the snakes could also seen out here. So this is the zone where the people actually come to meet themselves. People come to meet not only themselves, but people come to find themselves. Inner soul, they find themselves. So I'm actually making you to understand the second portion of this story, that is Coorg, which is given by Lochis Abraal. Now the fiercely independent people of Coorg are possibly actually coming from the Greek and Arabic descendants. It means that their forefathers may be from the Arabian countries or from the Greek, the Athenian countries too here, and that's how they have actually settled here. So it is also said that they may be the families from the Alexander's army too, as the Alexander's army moved from the southeast India only. So this is how we can say that traditional of the marriages, ceremonies, then other customary duties and all are quite different from the other place of India, and that is how the rituals can be somehow distinct also at that places, and mainstream of these people are locating themselves only internally, and they don't allow themselves to go just to out to businesses and all. They are happy in luck in their own business. This is the Coorg zone or the Coorg people. Now why Coorg is famous? See, according to the constitution, some vidhan, we can say that Coorg people were the first Matar people who supported nation India, and that's how the people who are actually relating with the army's family, marshals families and all, today also they are still free to keep any kind of weapon without any kind of license. So they don't need any kind of license because they are one of the trustable caste and person, a tribute to the nation. They are actually a life tribute to the nation, and this is how we can say these are actually one of the thing which is relating factor and making India also proudful here. Now as per the theory, if you go more further, then we can say marriages, religious ceremonies, okay, which are distinct from the Hindus and mainstream, actually relating to the Coorg zone also, somehow from the Hindus it can be different, but from the Coorg zone it is same. So therefore we can say the theory of the Arab origin draws the basic Coorg people and their get-ups too, like from the long black coat, then wearing of the hats and all, and also somehow eatable, their style of eating style, then their living style, and then what kinds of styles are also proving that they must belong to the Arabian families too here. As well, when they wear the embroidered waist belt, it is also actually known as kodavuz in the regional language, which is also known as the Kupia, K-U-P-P-I-A. So that's how I'm telling you about the Coorg and Coorg information too. If you have not seen inside the map, you must go and search on the YouTube too. You can find the proper region videographically, and you can imagine yourself also. So that's how Arab and Coorgs were also sitting together. They made themselves to come closer, and that's how this Coorgi zone was created. The Coorgi people were created. So if we move further, then Coorgi homes have traditional hospitality too. Now what is traditional hospitality? Traditional hospitality means whenever you go and visit this Coorg zone, what you'll find? You'll find that the people greet you in a different manner. Now what is the different manner? See, they are actually more willing you to account the nimbrance of the favor of their you can say drinks and all, generally the coffees. They'll support you to give it out or to just taste it out also. But not only this much, my dear student, if you talk about the Coorg regiment is also one of the trustable and most dedicated and most decorated in the Indian army. That the first chief of Indian army was a Kodavu, and that's how there are only the people in India who are permitted to carry the firins or the firearms also without any kind of license in the Coorgi zone, because they have supported India since from the ancient time. And that is how I can say that Coorg zone and the Coorgi people, their regiment, are worth trustable. But this is not ending here. Let's talk about the geographical location and the geographical we can say features of the Coorg. If you talk about the Coorg, then we can say that the river Kaveri, then Maheshir and etc. Maheshir, like a large fish basically, the river Kaveri obtains a water flow from the great forest of Coorg, and also Maheshir, a large freshwater fish that is also very less seen, is can be seen in the Coorg too, which is a special diet for the kingfishers. Actually they dive to get this kinds of fish. So therefore we can say that Coorg and Coorgi zone is specially making a hub for the men also and for the nature also, and they come closer in the case of theory. So therefore we can say that it is also another thing where the freshwater fish can be seen out here, as they catch the while the squirrels can be also seen out diving here and there from the trees to catch some kinds of other fruits and flowers, while the squirrels and langurs can be dropping some out of partially eat fruits seeds in the water to check out the ripple water, and they will be happy also. Sometimes they will also come in the contact with you, and be aware with the elephants whenever you are going in the Coorg. So it is giving me a goosebump. Why? Because I just think about the Coorg, I just feel that wow, what a place it could be that I must go and visit. And that's how I need to also taste the coffee in the region of the Coorg by the farm of the Coorgi people. So that will be giving you a special essence of the life and the life consistency also. So therefore we can say that the most of the land blocks individuals became converted to the life with their general theories about the adventurous and general purpose also. If you are actually relating yourself with the adventure, with the river rafting, with the mountain climbing, forest tracking, okay, hill climbing and all, then you must try to go Coorg. It will give you the most land back individual adventure there. It will give you the most land back individual adventure. So therefore we can say that here the adventurous camps are there, river rafting is there, you'll find most of the rappelling of the thread climbing is there, rock climbing is there, mountain trackings are there, forest tracking is there, jumping, bungee jumping, everything is there established in the small short of the land. And that's how I'm telling you, okay, backing in the zone of Coorg is also very thing. When you go back and you do some kinds of adventure, like biking is there, or hill climbing, swimming is there, river rafting is there. And if you don't do this kinds of thing, then you can just meditate yourself in the open environment of Coorg, and you'll get your inner soul speaking to you. So this is how we can say the Coorg zone is located. Now see, my dear student, whenever we are talking about India, it's not like we should talk always positive, but when it is negative, we should try to make it positive by improving the thought by guiding the people, by informing the government and all. And as much possible, we should generally go positive for the India. And you know that basically, India, Indian zone, Indian location, Indian people, food, lifestyle, cloth, custom, religion, festival, caste, region, everything is consisting its own beauty, its own theory, its own number. And that's how we need to understand that the zone of Kurgi people are also one of the zone which is actually located for the nature and the beauty. Birds, bees, monkeys, Malabar langurs, macaws, Malabar squirrels, this all can be seen there. And that is how Kurg zone is famous for. So therefore we can say that canopies are there. What is canopy? Canopy means the branches of the trees which are spread all over, and under that you'll find the houses of the marshals. It looks so interesting. So whenever you want to visit Kurg, you must visit that, and you should not cancel your plan too. A walk across the rope bridge is also giving you the best beauty of the nature. A walk across the road bridge into the Buddhist monk temple, and also you can find that India's largest Tibetan settlement can be also seen nearby, that at the Bylakpur, BYLAKPUR, that is in the Kurg only, and which is also a bonus part of that area. So therefore we can say that Nisargadham is also there, which is related to Buddhist, and all monks are getting there, all the salvation monks and all basically. And apart from that, they will be also dressed inside red clothes, inside their own traditional clothes, and they are wearing their props and all generally, and they are among walking together, they are praying together, which is also a surprising thing when you will go and visit the Kurg. So therefore we can say that if you want to really go inside the Kurg, you will discover your own heart. The visitors searching for the heart and soul of India right come into the Kurg, and they enjoy the situation. So this is actually the part of Kurg where we are understanding the coffee and the coffee production too here as well. If you can understand, then you can tell, you can generally know that Kurg is famous for coffee, Kanyakumari too, and tea also. It is famous same like Assam here. So that's how this part is actually depending upon the Kurg zone and the Kurgi part too. In the other lecture, we'll be moving towards the part of tea, where I will make you to understand two friends and their friendship. When one friend is taking, when Pranjal is taking Rajveer from a Delhi boy school, okay, or from a Delhi's boy family to the Assami boy family, what he will enjoy, that will be studying in the other part of the lecture. Till then you can take care, keep revising this. This is Glimpses of India, and I'm trying to make you understand about the basic theory related to the Indian custom and Indian tradition, old memories, and heaven of our beauty. Jai Hind.